Hello YouTube, welcome back. This is me, Hudson Team. So today I'm back with a new game, 2D game, fighter jet plane game. So without wasting time, let me show you the demo first. Here I just play the game. Here I start the game. Here I am moving my fighter plane jet. And here I'm firing the bullets. And here, as you see on the top left corner, the points are incrementing, and as I stuck with the particular enemy's plane, it turned into explosion and it stopped to falling, and game over and restart game. Here I click on restart, game restarts. So maybe this tutorial would be useful for the beginners, because we are not using any kind of graphics, but only a simple coding. So we're wasting time. Let's start it. Here is the final new project. Here I write fighter plane game. Okay. So here I set some of the properties, 1,500. 500 is less, I guess 600 would be useful maybe. Alright, now I'm just making up the layout first. Here is set back color from web. Sky blue. Here is set the sky blue. Now I just draw the picture box of my fighter plane. So the picture box is there. Here is the picture box, I draw the picture box and just choose the image. I just import the file from desktop, jetplane 1. Okay. And one more thing, I set the back color to transparent. Alright. Now, pressing control key, I just copy that. Now I choose the image for enemy planes. Okay. I select two types of enemies there. Remove that and copy these enemies. Here is my five planes enemies. So this look pretty enough. Now, alright. What I need to do now, I just set the name to enemy 1, 2, 3, enemy 1, enemy 2, enemy 3, enemy 4, and we apply it as well. Now here I write a fighter plane. Fighter. Alright. Now I need the label here. For the text urge 0. Let's set up the properties. For the properties, no, back oil look better, and full color yellow. Let's increase the size more. Alright, good enough. So that would be the scoreboard. No, copy that. I just typed it over and set the text to game over. Right, and in the back color to make it different. Now, here is the game over, and the last thing I need is the button, the restart button. Here I write restart, and let's set the text to restart game. Let's restart the game, and so it's pretty enough. And set the same color. And back color would be restart button. So now let's move to the coding part. One thing I just forget, that is bullet images. Choose image, import. Here is the bullet image. Alright, I just opened it up. Let's copy three bullets. I set bullet 1 bullet 2 and both bullet 3. So there are 3 bullets now. I think I just completed the design. So let's move to coding part. First of all, what I need to do is I need some timer. This would be for move enemies. So I write here enemy control. Enemy timer. Alright, so there is enemy timer. Here is another timer. It can control fires. These three fires are fire 1. Fire 2. Three as well. So here's the three timers. The M timer. So let's do a little calling part. First thing I need to do, I'll move this up and down. But before this, what I need to do, I want, when I start that game, this would be disappear and this disappear, and they will set to their particular position, this will disappear. Alright, so for that, alright, void start game. There are two. This is the hour label. This is restart. Over.visible is equal to false. And restart.visible is equal to false. Bullet1.visible is equal to false. Bullet2.visible is equal to false. Bullet3.visible is equal to false. So when I start the game, I need to execute this in an initialized component. So execute this function. So here you see there's no bullets, no start game, restart game, or not a game or whatever. Now let's set the enemies to their vertical position. And one total of left is equal to 1000. So first I'll show you there are now four things and he's right over there. Alright? So I just go there. So now start the game. Here you see there is only my four airplane. So now, let's go forward. Now I need to move this plane upside down. For that I just go to form events. Key down. There will be a key down function. Key down event true. Here's the key down. It's key press. I need key down. Here's the key down event. So now, in this part, what I need to do is if E dot key chord is equal to keys dot space and down. Fighter dot top is equal to minus 10 plus F E dot keycard is equal to keys dot up. spited or stop is plus is equal to 10. So now let's see what happens. Here is no. Where is the error now? I would like to know where is the error now. So here you see. Let's see what happens. So let's see what happens. Here you see I'm pressing up, it's going upside down. I need to set minus down. And now copy that. Paste over there. I set it down. And here, simple. Now here you see, plane is moving, bird is flying out of the boundary. So to control that, I need to set another if. Fight to the top. And fight it at the top, or less than 600. Now see, here you see it starts to the boundaries, but it's going downward, but how much downward to that? So I set it to 550 range. Now it would work perfectly. So it's working almost perfectly. I set it to 500. Alright. Now my fighter plane is moving correctly. Now the next step is to fire the bullets. I need to work on the fire timer. Bullets. In the fire one timer, bullet one will move. Here I need a technical calling. Here I write int bullet count is equal to 0. Bullet one dot visible is equal to true, and bullet one dot left is equal to plus is equal to 10. 10. Alright, and bullet 1 dot location is equal to 4 plane location, because where our 5 plane is, the bullet will come from that side or that location. So for that purpose, I hope that heard. In three timers, and set bullet 2, bullet 2, bullet 2, bullet 3, bullet 3, bullet 3, 3. Now, in this call, why I do this, when this timer will be enabled or set it to true, the bullet will start going like that. Now, here what I need to do is, I set the spacebar E dot key call is equal to keys dot spacebar. If bullet count, and now I use modulus of pressure dot 1 is equal to 0, I start first bullet, fire 1 dot enable is equal to true, and bullet count plus else if bullet count. I just copy now this code only. I set it to 2 and fire 2, that's it. And here is same 3 and 3, and here I write else and else. So let's see what happens now. It's not working correctly. There might be some problem. So let's see what's the problem here. What if I just enable the first timer? The bullet is stuck there, why? It's just stuck over there. answer now is very good. The mistake was that I said fighter location. I said bullet train location in timer, so it's there was repeatedly execute this line, so wasn't able to move the bullet. Now see what happens. Here you see I'm firing the three bullets, so bullets are working correctly. So now let's move to enemy park. To move the enemies, what I need to do is I make another function. Move void move. I just name it enemy. Now here I pass the arguments picture box enemy object. Alright. So now here I first of all I move all of the enemies from right to left. Now in the enemy timer is enabled to true for one. Now here I create the object of picture box and here I pass the enemies as I show you here. Just copy that and over there. Now I said move enemy. Here pass the name of images enemy one. Now let's play. There. I'm just moving. I'm just saying that. All right. This is working perfectly. I just want to move the enemies from right to left. In the enemy ticker, left plus is equal to 1. So let's see now. Minus 1, minus 10. So here you see, it's coming over there, and stuck there. Now all I need to do is to pass the another location. I just copy that code, cut there. Enemy object. Enemy object. Yeah, yeah, it's move enemy. Enemy one. Now save. Alright. Smooth very fastly, I type sound speed. Now all I need to do, when it collapses there, it comes over there. When it's stuck, this end is stuck there, boundary, it comes over there again. So let's see now what's happened. So as you see, it's coming over and over again. Here I create a random function. Random r is equal to new random. What I want basically, there, when this enemy comes from there, it should replace, it should change the location in y-axis. So y-axis should be from 100 to 400 in variation. So here I write dot point dot location dot x is equal to r dot next 100 comma 400. Now let's see. Enemy object dot new point dot points dot location is equal to points. 1000, comma, x-axis will be 1000 and y-axis will be r dot next into 100, comma, 400. So that will be pretty well, of course. Happening over there. And objective location is equal to new points. So basically there would be a problem in the points. Now, a new object of location is equal to new point 1000. That would be x-axis, and that would be y-axis, and that will be different. So, let's see what happens. Here you see it's coming from there, same again there, and now downside. So as you see, the point is coming from different location in x-axis and y-axis and same in x-axis. So I just copy that. I just need to draw it is moving 2, 3, 4, and 5. Here you see what I need to do. Whatever I code over there, I just need to pass the name of the my pictables enemy in the my created function. Now see the five of the enemy would be moving. As you see. So let's play the demo of our game. Now what I need to do when it's stuck to this, or when I'm able to fire to this, now I just pass another thing over there in enemies function f enemy object dot bounds dot intersect with fighter dot bounds. So now, I just change the game. I just change the image of my fighter plane, fighter dot image is equal to whatever over there. Properties dot resources dot. First of all, what I need to do is to import an image. Choose image. I import just. I just downloaded four-year MS. Okay, I again convert it to my Z file point. Now it's exploring image over there. Dot resources dot exploring. And restart button dot visible is equal to true and get over dot visible is equal to true and move enemy. All right, that's enough. Now see that happens. Here you see it's game over, and I just want to stop there. What I do is move enemy timer dot enable is equal to false. Now see what happens. When it's stuck to that, the game is over. Alright? So, let's make the restart by calling application to restart one of the simplest methods. So, here you see, when I start to that, it's restart the game, simple. Alright? Now, let's work on bullet scrolling. In enemy object, I write if bullet one dot bounce dot insect with enemy object dot bounce. I need one more curly brackets because I'm adding all condition. Copy that, paste that, all condition, copy that, paste that, bullet 3, bullet 2. Here I create in score variable is equal to 0 while I want to increment the int score plus plus and points dot text is equal to score dot to string. Here you see now I wonder when the bullet stuck to the white plane, the plane should be disappeared. So for that is and object of location. I just copy that same lines and set it there. Now I just play the game. Here you see that it disappears. So it's working perfectly. I need to slow down the enemy speeds. It should be 3 or 4. That's it. So now, that will be. So, here you see we successfully complete the game. Hope you enjoy this game and you will hopefully learn so many things. So, the score points will start the game, So, you can add so many things in that. So, don't forget to subscribe and stay tuned. Thank you.